The next item I want to talk about in this era of Kwonmunism is The West Wing. It's a TV series that I've known about, but haven't actually started watching until like a couple of days ago. So a couple of days ago is the first time I watched like a full episode of West Wing. I finished watching episode 5 yesterday, so that's where I'm at. Episode 5 of the first season. So that's where I'm at with West Wing. I'm a latecomer to the series, as I usually am with a lot of other series and video games. I'm a latecomer to most things, and to West Wing, I definitely am a latecomer. I know there are, looking at Netflix, there seems to be 7 seasons of West Wing. So it's going to take me a while to get through that. But I have a lot of time on my hand, I suppose, so I'll be watching a lot of West Wing. Each episode seems to be so packed of stuff. It's kind of like, it's not one of those shows where, it's not like Lost, you know. Lost was one of those series where I discovered on Netflix, and I just was just like, I watched one episode, and like, next. And I watched like 10 episodes in like one day. It was insane. I got so hooked onto that thing. West Wing, I think I see the potential for me in getting hooked. But one episode is just so full of dialogue and so full of thought-provoking scenarios that, like, I think I need time to, you know, after I watch an episode, I take the time to kind of digest it and think about what I just watched, what just happened, and just all the dialogues that happened, kind of just replay them in my mind and just like, whoa, and consider this scenario and that scenario. And that's starting to happen. The first 3 episodes, I think, I just kind of just watch back to back, because they're setting up this scene of what it's like working in the White House in the communications department as a chief of staff, deputy chief of staff, director of communications, and press secretary. So that's this angle of the White House, and of course the president, how he responds, you know, how he interacts with these communications department, and how he interacts with what happens in the country and around the world. That's kind of the premise of The West Wing. It's a powerful premise, actually. I think, which is why West Wing, you know, has won so many awards or was nominated for so many awards. Really sharp writing. And I really love all the characters that so far are introduced and established in the series so far. But yeah, the first 3 episodes, I kind of just watched them back to back. Kind of has a slow beginning. I think it's just to establish this setting. But I really like, you know, how smart these characters are, how, you know, cocky and arrogant a lot of these characters are, but a lot of these characters have their own nuances and flair to them. It's really interesting how they interact with each other. In particular, I really like how President Bartlett and Toby interact with each other. Jed Bartlett is the President of the United States, who's, you know, can be considered as the most powerful man in the free world, and yet sometimes, especially when we reach episode 5, Toby interacts with him like he would, you know, his favorite teacher or something. You know, there is this tension between them that happens, and that tension is overcome by, you know, camaraderie and solidarity. So far, you know, it has a slow beginning. I know it's going to get so much more intense in the later episode, in the later seasons. So far, I'm kind of getting introduced to it. I'm really liking it. It's really awesome. I feel like I should have discovered watched West Wing much sooner. It's a very thought-provoking series. I particularly like the episode number 3, where it talks about how, you know, the White House tries to pass this gun control legislation bill. And it's not happening because these 5 Democrats are refusing to vote yes on it. And so the White House Communications Department kind of strong-arms them or uses their persuasive methods, which looks kind of like coercion in a way. There's a lot of threatening, backroom dealing, social dealing. It's really, you know, negotiations where one of them is in which, like, yeah, I will agree to vote this bill if you allow me to have, you know, spend some time with the president with full press, you know, comment, so that it makes me look good. So they trade like this press, something that, you know, would look good to the press for the senator. He trades that recognition for his yes on the bill, which is insane, you know. But that, I guess this is the reality of politics in America and probably in many other parts of the world. Politics is a dirty game, and the West Wing kind of shows the imagined reality of it, I think. Because, you know, this is the Hollywood writer's imagination of how West Wing or how the White House works, which to me seems very plausible. It seems very realistic how the West Wing handles the subject matter. But yeah, I found that to be a really interesting episode because of the game of politics involved in passing this gun control legislation bill. The merits of this legislation isn't really even talked about that much. There is one scene when Leo meets this Leo, the chief of staff, meets with a senator who, you know, who's African American, and they Leo kind of mentions like this bill would be really great for the African American communities, and this senator knows the bill like inside and out and just recites to him and just responses, no, this bill actually wouldn't do anything. And that's when the kind of the merit of the bill is talked about. But in most instances, about trying to pass this bill, it's not the merit, but it's the political game of who comes out on top. And in the end, the vice president comes out on top in the end. So they kind of win the battle, but the war of political power is kind of lost among the White House, because the vice president, it seems like it's starting to establish him as some sort of like a rival or an enemy to the president. So that's going to be interesting to see how that rivalry plays out for me, because this is my first time watching the series and I don't know how this is going to go. I haven't spoiled myself yet, but I don't mind about spoilers. So really, you can comment whatever you want about it if you want on the comment section below. There's that. Episode number 4 was a really powerful episode, because that episode is the first time where President Jed Bartlett has to deal with military response to a terrorist attack. Or not a terrorist attack, but to an attack made by a Syrian government taking down a helicopter. And inside the helicopter was one of, you know, a person that he got really close to, like a medical chief who he became really friendly and close with. And President Bartlett becomes so emotionally upset that he questions this idea of a proportional response. And that's when the American government responds to an attack proportionally. A helicopter was taken down. In response, the United States government would attack on a communications installation, or would blow up an intelligence headquarters. That's the proportional response. And President Jed Bartlett is just like so upset. He's just like, no, that's not enough. That sends a wrong message. And there's this one scene which I thought to be such a powerful scene, in which President Jed Bartlett and Leo kind of just have a back and forth really strong debate and discussion. And Jed's like, what happened? What about the Roman Empire? There was a time in the Roman Empire, and this is not verbatim, I don't remember the quote verbatim, but this is kind of what he said. There was a time in the Roman Empire when a Roman citizen could walk about anywhere in the world freely and not worry about being harmed, because he held this piece of paper that claimed of his Roman citizenship. As a Roman citizen, if he was harmed, the retribution to that, you know, the justice for a Roman citizen being harmed or being killed would be so swift and so brutal that everyone in the known world knew that you don't harm a Roman citizen. And he's saying that a proportional response to a this downed helicopter is sending the message that, you know, you can harm an American citizen without expecting a terrible retribution. So he starts having justification for an insane counterattack. You know, the insane counterattack is to blow up this airfield in Syria, which would harm so many innocent lives that it would almost be like a declaration of war against Syria. And it would be like a ridiculous situation. But, you know, he gets so emotionally invested. It really tells you that, you know, the president can be, as the most powerful person in that position, can be so emotionally bothered in something, you know, that can happen. And there's that discussion. And ultimately what happened is the proportional response, because there's this whole back and forth debate. But I found that to be such an interesting thing. As I watch more and more West Wing, I definitely, you know, see myself getting more and more invested. And having more of these, like, thought-provoking questions in my head, I find this series to be really thought-provoking. And it's really awesome. I think it's really sharp writing so far. Really like all the characters and the interactions with them. So that's definitely my experience with West Wing so far. It's pretty crazy, I know, that I've started watching this series as such a latecomer. But yeah, those are my thoughts on the West Wing so far. And I'll probably do more videos in which I talk about West Wing the more I watch it.